Question number 8. Now, there are two static negative charges. These are the two static negative charges. And this is the dynamic charge, capital Q. Now, static charges make force, electric field and potential. Dynamic charge, it does not make the electric field or any kind of, I mean that potential or E. So, capital Q is here, two negative charges are here. This is plus, minus, it remains attraction force. So, always this negative charge attracts capital Q towards itself. So, effects here. Now, according to Coulomb's law, when they have same charges and same distances, F also same. So when I label these two forces on capital Q, that should be same. With respect to the angle also, theta, theta. Now you can see, when you take the result component parallel to the vertical direction, they act opposite directions. So, vertical result components cut with each other, it remains horizontal direction resultant force. That's why Q travels right direction like this, from here to there. But when R is at infinity, when R is at infinity, F becomes zero. So again, now Q comes here, I mean the origin, when it comes here, again, resultant force becomes zero. So when you draw the variation, I mean, when you label force on capital Q, it has three zero points. At minus infinity, when R becomes infinity, F becomes zero. At the plus infinity, same. But when capital Q is at origin, at that time, it gives opposite direction forces. So it has three zero points. Minus infinity, origin and plus infinity. But when the Q is at here, it has resultant force. Between the two zero points, when it has any kind of force, that should be the maximum. And F inversely proportional to distance, so it has the curve like a tangential when it increases or decreases. So when I draw the variation force on capital Q, it has three zero points, minus infinity, plus infinity, and the origin. In this point it has force, so inversely proportional means that's curve. This is the variation of force on capital Q, force on capital Q relative to the distance. Now actually this is the question in English medium, but when I give the graphs, I've done some mistakes. So that's why this should be the graph on English medium. So that's why I gave you all. Now this is the force on capital Q relative to the distance. But in the single medium, now actually they ask the resultant force on negative charge when it comes here. Now actually, you can write that F is given by this Coulomb's law, K is OK when it comes here. Now, this is the force on capital Q. Now, when capital Q is here, when it comes like this, when the Q is at origin, it has the least distance. When distance takes minimum value, F goes to the maximum value. This is the variation of F. This is the variation of F on negative charge, because when the charge are different but force is equal. So this is the variation of force on negative charge related to the distance, because at the infinity it becomes zero, minus infinity becomes zero, at plus infinity becomes zero, but q is at here, I mean that origin, it takes the maximum value, for because that the distance takes minimum value.